Ganesha ate the last sackful of rice as well. He ate it uncooked, scattering it all over the floor. He entered the kitchen and ate the fruit and vegetable peels. He ate the spices and the soil. He sauntered into Kubera's orchards and ate all the fruit hanging from the trees. Papayas, jackfruits, apples, chicos, every single fruit he gobbled. He went into the cowsheds and drank all the milk. He drank the water from the perfume fountains and left them dry. Stop, Ganesha. Please, please stop. What are you doing there? Ganesha paid no heed to Kubera, but went on towards the kitchen. Now, he tore down doors and ripped cupboards in search of more food. Frightened, Kubera ran to Shiva and fell at his feet.
Help me, Lord Shiva! Your son has gone mad! His appetite is spiteling. Please stop him before he destroys my palace completely!
And you thought it would be easy to please Ganesha? Tell me this, Kubera, and be honest. Did you invite us for a meal to your palace to honor us or to show off your wealth?
Forgive me, Shiva. I only wanted to pose to Kubera. I wanted you to come and admire my wealth so that I may be talked about among the gods. Please forgive me.
You silly fool. Now go back to your palace. Here, take this fistful of rice. Offer it to Ganesha with humility. He will be satisfied.
Kubera rushed back to his palace, which was being torn to the ground. He fell at Ganesha's feet and offered him a fistful of rice.
Please, Ganesha. Forgive me, Kubera. I was so mean. Please accept this with love.
Ganesha accepted Kubera's humble offering, and his hunger was at last sated.
Well, fine. Great feast, Kubera. Perhaps you'll invite me again next week, huh?